My husband and children were killed recently.
I'm sorry. We'll do our very best to sell it as quickly as possible.
Thank you.
Oh, well, you'll come back all tanned and looking relaxed.
Doubt it, under the circumstances.
No?
Yeah, my father's been referred to a specialist in Sydney. I'm going to go with him.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realise. Well, this is a follow-up to the strike, is it?
It's a follow-up to whatever Keane and those thugs did to him during the escape.
What a nasty business. How old is he again?
Well, age has got nothing to do with it. He's a very fit man.
Oh, that's good. So what does the doctor have to say?
The doctor? The very reason we've got to go to Sydney is his inability to diagnose the problem.
Miss Ferguson, I just wanted to say goodbye before I left. I hope everything goes well for your father.
Yeah, me too. I'll see you when you get back.
Yeah, thanks.
All right, Governor.
Night, Trip. I might have a look at the rosters. Meg had to make some changes.
Look, I'm sorry to be taking leave when we seem to be having so many problems around here.
Don't be silly. Family comes first. Anyway, Colleen feels that she can handle full-time work again.
Huh? Is she returning as Deputy Governor?
No, Meg will continue as Deputy Governor for the moment. Colleen's still under a lot of strain and I want to make sure she has an easy workload.
Yes, of course. I hope the department hasn't regretted rescinding my resignation.
No, of course not. Why?
Well, there doesn't seem to be much communication from them, except what you tell me. It's almost as if they're giving me the cold shoulder.
I'm afraid it'll be some time before they forget that you were prepared to help a prisoner escape.
They must have realised why.
You wouldn't be back here if they hadn't. But you know the department. Cold, hard facts on official reports never look good.
So now I'm a security risk, eh? That's marvellous, isn't it? All those years of hard work and now I've got to prove myself all over again.
Yes, well, are you flying off tonight?
No, I don't finish till late. I'll catch a plane in the morning.
Oh, you should have spoken to Meg. She could have changed the roster.
It doesn't matter. A few things I have to do before I go. Well, I'll say goodbye. See you when I get back.
Yes, goodbye. And look after your father.
Thanks.
G'day.
Hello.
Got a bit of a surprise when Gino set out to meet you. What's going on?
They're worried about your attitude and I said I'd try and straighten you out. If I can't. Then they'll let Gino have you. You know what that means. You'll just disappear.
What have I been doing wrong?
Apparently you have been uncooperative.
Uncooperative? What the bloody hell do
they
expect?
Keep your voice down. Little watchdog over there is just as likely to repeat every word you say to Rinna.
Yeah, well, I've had to deal with some real creeps and Gino's one of them. I'm not kidding. The things that guy makes me do are sick.
It's all part of the job.
All right for you, isn't it?
Oh, listen, you're not the only one who has to grin and bear it. I've got to put up with Rinna pouring me and he turns my stomach.
Yeah, well, I don't know how much longer I can put up with it. I just shoot through.
With people like that, you don't just shoot through. Gino seems to think you're not worth the trouble.
He's a bastard.
Look, I have stuck my neck out for you a couple of times and I'm not going to do it anymore. One more bad report from you and I might just have to say to Rinna, I think that he should get rid of you. Permanently.
Well, well. You will have to learn to control that temper of yours, Gaffney.
I never done this.
Really? Who did then?
Beats me.
Oh. Must have been someone with a grudge against you. Or perhaps it was just someone wanting to steal something. That is, of course, a theory, isn't it?
I've got nothing worth stealing, Miss Ferguson.
Well, I'd say the person who did this doesn't believe you. And you know what, Gaffney? I think they'll try again.
But that'd be a waste of time, Miss Ferguson. Like I said, I've got nothing
worth
stealing.
You know, Gaffney, there is one truth in Wentworth. And that is you can't keep your little treasures hidden forever. It's only a matter of time. I get this mess cleaned up before I put you on a charge.
Right, Miss Ferguson.
Mm.
Here's to a night off. And your release from isolation.
Shouldn't you be slaving over a hot stove?
No. Casserole's in the oven, and the dessert is straight out of the supermarket deep freeze. Sit down.
You're very organised, aren't you?
Well, I'm not really. I mean, we were supposed to be having soup tonight, but I just forgot all about it. Don't know what's happening to me lately.
Well, you're a lot more domesticated than I am. When you're on the force, you learn to live out of hamburger bars and things.
Oh, well, I enjoy cooking. It's not so much fun on your own. That's why it's been rather nice having Colleen here.
Yeah, isn't she meant to be here tonight?
Oh, maybe later. She's out with a neighbour and then couldn't get out of a dinner invitation. Stop worrying, Rick. She doesn't blame you for what happened.
Yeah, all the same, I'd feel a lot better if I could help in some way.
Well, I think she's over the worst of the shock now. And even if she does sell the house, I hope she doesn't try living on her own too quickly.
Do you ever spend any time to worry about yourself?
Of course I do. But you know what it's like living on your own. You get used to it.
Yeah.
Anyway, how could you ask anyone to share the life that we lead with our sort of job?
Well, if I ever find a lady to take Celia's place, this job is going to run a very poor second.
Mr. Manning, I wish you happy hunting.
Hi. Sorry I'm late. I got held up at the public trustee office.
Late? I didn't think you were going to get home till after 10. I thought you were with a neighbour.
No, that was put off till next week. I told you this afternoon, remember?
Yes.
Hoping there's some cold water. Isn't there enough? I can always get takeaway.
Well, there's plenty. You could make yourself useful and set the table.
All right, done.
You want a hand?
No. Sit there and relax.
Come on, Jude, how about a song? I heard that you do Louis Armstrong real good. Or what about Kenny Rogers?
Oh, no, the Deltones.
Oh, yeah, we'll take a vote. Hey, Margo, what do you want, Kenny Rogers or the Deltones?
Oh. I want the bitch who turned my cell over.
Don't you start throwing your muscle around here, Gaffney. You might bite off more than you can chew.
Desmond may be in the pound, but I know she ordered it.
Well, before you start pointing your finger around in here, why don't you look to your own mates? I bet they'd do anything to get their hands on that dope.
Yeah, what about Reb or Weasel?
As a matter of fact, you might as well just give it to them. Because when Myra gets out of the pound, you are going to be out of business.
Don't count on it. The women want a top dog who'll give them what they want. Then you'll be the one sweating Bryant.
We'll stick with Myra, Jude.
Yeah, I reckon most people will. She'll look after us.
Yeah, I hope so. But she's got to face a charge over Gloria. And then she has a murder trial. How much can she take?
Yes. Excuse me, I don't know how you got past the monkey downstairs, but I can always call him and have you removed.
I'm Libby Blake.
So you're Libby. Looking for a job.
You're on my turf.
Look, Kurt's going to be home very soon. I suggest you leave now.
I came to see Kurt. He didn't come to waste time with his latest little tart.
It's funny being a has-been. You always have to be told twice.
You listen to me, you little bitch.
Temper, Libby. What is it today? Haven't you had your fix? Oh, yes, Kurt told me all about your expensive little habit. He told me he was sick of it and sick of you. I'm sorry, Libby. You're out. I'm in. Well, now that you've finished your drink, I suggest you leave.
I've still got heavy friends, Stevens. Let's see how long Kurt keeps you around after they've done a face job on you.
Comfortable, Desmond?
I don't have to talk to you.
Oh, I just thought you'd like to know I'll be gone for a few days. That ought to cheer you up. But I won't miss you too much, Desmond, because you'll be here when I get back. Yeah, you'll be convicted of murder. Payne's evidence will see to that. No, I don't expect you to enjoy your trial too much, but I certainly...